We wanted to show you this beautiful shot this morning. And a 9-year-old boy in Texas getting national attention for an unusual pastime. Why? Look at this.
There you go. All right, Shark Boy. Keep him up. Keep him up. And do what? There he is. A nice little black tip. So they're here.
A nice little black tip. That is Hunter Stevens, or Shark Boy, as he is called by his dad. That was on Sunday, and they were catching a black tip shark off the coast of Galveston. It's his first of the season. Hunter and his dad, Kevin, are with us this morning from Houston. Thank you so much for joining us. Hunter, I'm going to start with you. So judging by your reaction there, it seemed like it was very exciting for you. What were you thinking as you were reeling in that big shark?
I was thinking it was a fish the whole time, but then when it came up, it was a nice big shark.
Now, you were on a kayak, right? At least that's what we were reporting, that you're on a kayak. Is this just a little kayak in the middle of a big ocean?
No, it's a big kayak.
A big. Are you worried at all when you have a shark on the reel that perhaps you could fall over?
I never get worried with the shark or anything on a kayak.
And why is that?
There you go, your first black tip of the...
Because I know that none of the fish out there can hurt you.
Did you just say that the shark is not going to hurt you?
They don't talk to you.
No. They're very nice creatures if you don't hurt them.
Oh, so Dad, you were telling him to hold the line tight, not to let the shark pull you over. So it's a legitimate concern I have here, right?
Well, it's a slight risk, but I think you'd be more likely to get struck by lightning than fall over and get bit by a shark on a kayak. Although we did hook onto a shark, we don't set the drag heavy enough for it to actually pull him over. I was actually just joking with him.
Oh, okay. And where's Mom in all of this? Does she know that you're out in a kayak fishing
for sharks?
She's usually
at the beachfront. She knows we do it. We don't just fish for shark, but that's typically what we catch this time of the year. She sits on the beachfront and watches from a distance.
And Hunter, are you surprised by all of the attention that you're getting?
Yes, I'm very surprised.
And why? Don't you think it's unusual for a little boy to be fishing for sharks?
Well, this isn't our first time.
Oh, well, tell me about your first time.
Our first time, we actually caught a little bit bigger of a shark. It was 7 feet.
Well, you know, somebody on Facebook wanted to know why a fascination with sharks. Can you answer that question?
Why do you like sharks?
Oh,
I'm sorry. Why do you like sharks?
I like sharks because I know that they're nice and they're very, very beautiful. And they are amazing creatures to watch. They're like almost like dinosaurs when they eat, and they are very cool because you can learn more information about them every day.
Wow. And Kevin, you said that this was the first of this season. How many sharks do you likely catch in a season?
Well, it depends. Last year, it wasn't that great. We caught about 50.
And do you typically catch and release? Because that's another big question that folks are asking on Facebook.
Yes, we always catch and release.
All right, here's another one of your videos, because I know that Hunter said this is not the first time. So I want folks to watch this, because it was a bigger shark, and then I want to ask you a question about it.
Right there he is.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, Daddy.
There's a shark.
That's a big boy.
Keep the video on him.
Got him. Beauty, huh?
There he is.
Oh, yeah.
Hold on, let me see if I can get his teeth up.
Oh, my goodness. How big was that one?
7 feet.
7 feet. What were you thinking when that happened?
That was my first year at kayaking, so I was nervous. Scared, and happy, combined.
Okay, so I got it. But first of all, how big are you compared to the size of that shark? Do you know how tall you are?
Probably 4 feet and a half.
Okay, so a lot smaller than that shark. So I gotta get back to this concept of being on a kayak. And Dad, this question is for you. Is this safe to do?
If you know what you're doing, it's safe. It's relatively safe. You know, every adventure has a little bit of a risk to it, but it's not something you do. You don't go out and buy a kayak and go off the beachfront and fish for sharks. I'll tell you that. So you need to know what you're doing. You need safety first and take all the precautions like, number one, wear a life jacket.
Yeah, that's very good advice. So what's next? I hear perhaps a reality show?
We have something in the works, so it looks like it's actually going to, they've been working on it for a while, but it looks like it's going to happen. So you'll have to stay tuned.
This is the beauty of live television. Hunter's a little tired, so he was yawning there. And Kevin, I've got to congratulate you because I know that you instilled this passion in your child, and at the end of the day, that's what we always want to see, is that passion shine through. So thank you so much for joining us. Good luck to you, Hunter. When you catch the bigger one, come back, okay?
Okay.
All right, nice talking to you both. Thank you. Ashley, back to
Bye.
You.
I'm changing his name from Shark Boy to Shark Man. That's a great kid. Holy
Shark
moly.
Hunter.
Shark Hunter Soledad O'Brien joining us.
Like
We've
it.
Been sitting through this whole interview together
He's
thinking,
so cute
oh my
and
God.
Sleepy.
Could you imagine doing that with your child, though, on a kayak?
No, and if their dad took him out on the kayak well, to go
kill
home.
Him for sure.
Yeah.
I'd kill him.
Pretty much.
Well, those are the moms in us, though, right?
Yeah. So